some kind of discretionary spending for your business. So make sure, whatever, if you need $50,000 a year for your personal, make sure you make $100,000. But in the first year, it's okay if you cannot take away 10% and put towards this or 30% here. I mean, you can work that out. But after your first year, then that's, from what I hear in financial terms, only 50% of what you make in business should translate to your personal. Because if you don't put money back into your business, it's going to stop. And next year will be a tough one.
But I mean, like, what I'm saying is, like, when you're trying to figure out your business budget, like, should you, like, think about cards, signs?
You could, but all of the won't cost you any more than $1,800 a year. Because signs are reusable. Cards, how many cards? Like $100, you'll get 5,000 cards. If you can go through that, you better get some business out of this. I'm serious. Yeah. I mean, other than putting that in the for the wrap. Yeah. But
yeah, and when you're new in the business, even if you've been in the business for a while, you try so many different things, you just kind of start rolling. You know, you don't really know what's effective. Like the guy today who's come up, is this effective? It shows you all this stuff. I see these graphs all the time. They mean nothing to me, really. I mean, yeah, I get data from them, but it's not, I guess it's not giving me what I need. So,
see, as a business, right? As a businessman, Suzanne and we all started at the same time, 2015. We didn't have the revenue to do a lot of marketing for United.
Yeah.
So what we did, $10, you put $10 in a Facebook account and boost some. So that's how you start, even if you are a microcosm of what we do as a company, individually, right? So you take only $5, $10 in marketing. So you don't have to have a budget in your first year for marketing. Just take $10 here, $10 there, whatever. As you start making money, you become more organized like we did. Now we have a budget for pretty much everything. Mm-hmm. And when you get to that point, I mean, you're too big to fail, so you better keep that going.
Yeah.
I mean,
someone told me, do what you will do. You know what I mean? I mean, I respond to realtor.com, so that's what I do. I respond to door, so that's what I do. I don't do Instagram, 3-4 posts while the girl is talking, and you throw your phone out the dang window.
She posted 4 times to Instagram when Debbie was talking.
And
case
in point,
good things, too. I'm like, yeah. I want to take a picture of that.
Instagram. Anyway, whatever you will do, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Whatever you, because doing something that you're not going to respond to, I'm not going to get on Facebook and respond. I'm not going to get on. I just won't. I don't know why, because I was born in 1965, I guess. But I'll go door to door.
Spending money is not always the fix either. Spending money is not always the fix.
Yeah.
So, case in point, Cody Preston. He has 4 or 5 billboards. I am not a billboard kind of person.
What?
Person. You don't want to be a big size of me. But what works for you works for you. I mean, that's for you to decide. I'm not saying Cody. Cody did a brilliant job marketing himself. I mean, my church, they don't know that I even have a real estate company, but they don't know. I'm fine with that. Again, I'm more Preston, and for the most part, Joe. I don't know how I surround myself with low-key people. We have very low-key people. I mean, you won't hear much from us. But if you have a problem, we're there to answer. I think that's what a broker's job is to be that steady force that can answer all your questions, and not get into controversies on outside of what we do. We never post anything that's so stuff like that.